Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar. Allah is so merciful that He presents you with challenges in life in the hope that if you rise to the occasion, you get the opportunity to be stronger in your faith, to increase your iman. Allah reminds us all throughout the Quran that this life is a test, that surely we will meet death one day, and we will hope that we will be the ones who can be returning thankful, returning well-pleased, and returned well-pleasing. I look at this story, this case that I went through, and I'm realizing that Allah loved me so much that all throughout the journey, I remembered Him. I had to hold on to the rope of Allah in a way that you could not imagine. As a 15-year-old child, born as a Muslim, prior to that, everything I knew was theory. I say theory because I never had the opportunity to test anything as it related to my faith. The perhaps greatest challenge was when someone said, "What's your name?" And I said, "Yusef," and they messed up my whole name and called me Joseph. I'm sure some of you have had that experience. As a matter of fact, growing up in the 70s and in the 80s, it seemed as if people had a speech impediment when it came to Muslim names. Now it's so common, it's very easy. You know, people are shocked if your name is not Muslim. But this case is actually very interesting. In my book, Better Not Bitter, I've been known to call this case the Central Park Jogger case, a love story between God and His people. I call it that because Allah allowed the Central Park Jogger case for me to produce a miracle in modern time. It was as if the whole criminal justice system was placed on trial because of my case. It was the consideration of our humanity to understand what the criminal legal system is about and has been about for many of us who have the so-called complexion for rejection. That they will look at you and judge you by the color of your skin and not the content of your character. As a matter of fact, the system itself tries to change your mind from the memory of Allah to vengeance. It takes you off the path. But Allah took me through this journey, and I call it now the love story between God and His people. A story where the criminal justice system is placed on trial in order to produce a miracle in modern time. A story where people can be brought low only to rise because the truth can never stay buried. It's a story where we were buried alive and forgotten, but the system forgot we were seeds. And instead of a social death, we've been able to emerge like the phoenix from the ashes. Because as they built the fire to consume us, they forgot the owner of the heat. Allah blesses us if we are cognizant of it to be binded to the faith. Allah uses these things called trials, these things called unfortunate experiences, Because he reminds us in the Quran that nothing happens to us that we can't bear. All that is asked of us is that we hold on to the rope of Allah. This award is a beautiful award. This award is a heavy award. This award reminds me that as I continue on my journey, that I continue to champion the cause of justice. When I was in prison, a question was asked of me, a simple question. That question was, who are you? It was a question that perplexed me, because when I answered the question, I realized that I did not answer the question. I said, I'm Yusef Salaam, one of the guys they accused of raping the Central Park jogger, but I didn't do it. The officer asking me this question said, I know that. He told me that he had been watching me. He said, I wasn't supposed to be there. Again, he asked me, who are you? I think he was trying to spark wisdom and understanding into me so that I can go on the journey that often in the black and brown community we call Sankofa. Sankofa is the idea or concept that you have to return back to retrieve something. But when you turn back in Islam to retrieve something, you realize that you have all that you need for the journey. I started to find out, really, what the meaning of my name was. And I found out that Yusuf means God will increase. And as many Muslims, I have a long name for a name. I don't just have a first name and last name. I have like a whole sentence, as we must all do. And my second name is Idris, which is translated in many books as the teacher. And then Fa'adl. Fa'adl. With justice. And everybody knows Salaam means peace. In prison, I found out because of this question that was asked of me, who are you? I found out that when my mother and my father were waiting to name me, and they presented me in front of the community at the baby naming ceremony 7 days later, that they told the community that I was to be known as Yusef Idris Fa'adl Abdus Salaam, but I never knew what my name meant. And so here I was on this journey of oppression, finding out that my parents named me God Will Increase, the teacher, with justice and peace. It gave me a whole different outlook on life. It gave me an understanding that we have everything we need in order to live this thing called life. And all we have to do is hold on. If we hold on just a little bit longer, we will see the light at the end of the tunnel. And if we really want to shake things up, project yourself into the future. Imagine yourself and know that you are not where you're going to be in this present condition. Project yourself into the future so that you can know what you want to bring into yourself. You can look at yourself and say, one day, I will be one of the elders in the community. What do I want to look like? What do I want to be like? How do I want to be presented as an elder in the community? One day, I will be an ancestor in the community. What legacy do I want to leave? That dash between your life and your death. My good friend Les Brown often says, do not leave this world without a trace. And so how do we do that? We do that sometimes by putting on the glasses of Islam in order to Islamicize everything that we see. And so I get the opportunity to look at celebrities and say, you know, the great philosopher, Cardi B? Y'all know the great philosopher Cardi B, right? She said, knock me down 9 times, I'll get up 10. If you get the opportunity to fall on your back, Allah has been merciful to you. Because if you can look up, you can get up. But oftentimes we fall flat on our face. And through the hurt and pain, as we writhe in it, sometimes it's enough for us to be able to realize that we haven't died yet, and then we turn over. And if we can look up, we can get up. We can take the experience of being knocked down by the proverbial 2x4 of life and realize that you want to be a diamond. You want a life that is reflective of goodness. But in order to become a diamond, you have to withstand tremendous pressure. And more pressure after that. And then more pressure. And then the real test of if you're a diamond or not is when they cut you. Because if you can't get cut, if life can't cut you, if you take the licks and the things that life throws at you, the lemons that life gives you, and you say, thank you, may I have another, and you start squeezing the lemons and making lemonade, imagine what that does to the people who counted you out. They built a stage for us as 14, 15, and 16-year-old children 33 years ago. I mean, think about that. I could have never projected myself into a future 33 years later. I'll soon be 50 years old. Inshallah. Inshallah. Always remember that. Allah says, you cannot will unless Allah wills. And Allah says, do not say you will do something tomorrow unless you say, inshallah. And so, I encourage you all, as we all become champions of justice, to examine the life that Allah gave us, to see how we can use our life not only for ourselves, because once you get it, now you have to tell the world about it. Now you get the opportunity to tell everyone how great Allah is. And so I want to leave you with this poem. This poem was never revised. It's called, I'll Meet You in Between Venus and Mars. In between Venus and Mars is the center of our attraction. Of those connected to the stars, hardly a fraction. It behooves man to work for the day when this will all end. Life is mortal, so follow the malat of those who have been heaven sent. Awaken and receive that which will give you life, or remain horizontal and never begin the flight. For the solution, I'll descend from amongst the stars, and I'll meet you in between Venus and Mars. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.